These
noodles from northwestern China are incredibly al dente, and their texture is achieved by pulling the dough. This is why they call it la mian. In Chinese, la means pool and mian means noodle.
有十二种，十二种里面包括就是有圆形的、扁形的，还有就是花样面形的。
China is noodle heaven. Wheat noodles, rice noodles, thin, thick, the list of options is endless. In our first season of Eat China, we introduced four main regions of Chinese cuisine. This episode is all about noodles. We'll be featuring different kinds of Chinese noodles and show you how they're made. First up, hand-pulled noodles from Lanzhou. Lanzhou is an arid city in northwestern China that straddles the Yellow River. It's a city that runs on noodles.
我们的拉面店是早上六点半就开始经营了。兰州人就是喜欢早上大清早吃一碗牛肉拉面。我叫李兆红，我们的这个品牌呢叫顶牛兰州牛肉面，创建于2005年，现在有100多家店。当时我们在兰州有6所拉面店，因为在开店的过程当中呢，发现这个拉面师比较短缺，所以后面呢我们就办了一所学校。起初是为了给我们自己培养这个拉面师，做的过程当中呢发现其实所有的这个拉面店都缺这个拉面师。
So what exactly does noodle school entail?
因为这所学校老师他们就是手把手支教嘛，然后学得更快。
我在学校的一天从早上8点钟上课，早上上4节课，到中午11点40开始吃饭休息，下午2点钟上课到下午4点半，休息完之后到晚上7点到8点是一个小时的晚自习。
我们的学员进来都是从零基础开始啊，因为他们很多人都是95%都是没有做过这一行业。一般的学员从进来到毕业啊需要30天的时间。
Their strategy is to train students for a month through repetition. Here's what they do every day. First, they weigh the dough, and then combine it with this synthetic ash. They mix it together with salt and water, and then rip it apart, knead, twirl,and then pull. The students aren't given a recipe. The belief is that practice makes perfect.These steps are done over and over and over again until pulling noodles becomes a natural instinct.
我来这儿学习一共26天，我觉得做拉面最困难的部分就是和面。
拉面的时候，这个左手收面的时候，这个有点不自然的，还有就是三脚架什么的。
我叫樊继梅。教学拉面2年了，然后2年下来教了就是1000左右。最困难的部分就是掌握这个面的软硬，还有就是加灰的这个控制。
The ash is what gives these noodles its signature elastic texture. The main derivative is potassium carbonate, which increases the chewiness of the dough.
红灰的作用就是起到让这个面的增加的柔韧性。然后现在咱们用的是拉面剂，拉面剂跟蓬灰的成分是一样的。
And when the noodles are pulled and cooked, they're served in a savory beef broth with chili oil and thin slices of beef and turnip.
兰州牛肉面它实际这个食材是非常讲究的， 因为它的这个熬制这个汤的时候，里面放的都是些名贵的一些中药材，经过慢火熬制，所以它这个汤是非常有营养的。这个牛肉是用的我们甘肃河西走廊的牛的一些品种。它这种牛肉肉质要比较细滑啊，然后它的这个没有那么大的那种腥味儿啊，所以而且它这个肉质呢，非常有营养。
It's a lot of work for just one bowl of noodles. But for people in Lanzhou, it's a preferred way to start the day. Fun fact, the word 拉面 is actually where ramen gets its name from.These are biang biang noodles. The word biang comes from this action. They're a staple of Xi'an, a city in northwestern China. And it also happens to be the most complicated Chinese character in the world.
Biang biang 面嘛，在整个陕西西安这一块咸阳，它就是大家必不可少的。
Xi'an has been making noodles for over 1,000 years. It was the starting point of the Silk Road and historically known for growing wheat.
Xi'an is China's面食之都, because the 陕西人都爱吃面, 天天都离不了一碗面, 所以才被称为面食之都。
There are over 2 dozen types of noodles in Xi'an alone, but biang biang noodles are the most popular.
大家好，我叫王梅，我就是这豆家面馆的老板。像我们这个饭馆的话，它一天制作的话，大概就是500多碗面。它还有一个这个口诀呢，然后就是说是一个群秀才嘛，他到店里去吃饭了，然后没钱给人家老板，他自己想了想说，我没钱给你。你这个店也没有个名字啊、哦，我给你起个名字吧。老板说是，那你起吧，你起好了我就分文不收。然后他想了想，看老板扯面的时候，案板上这甩得很有劲儿，彪彪。然后他自己就创造了一个这个，就是现在这个彪字，它是好多个字组到一起的，但是你字典上查是绝对没有的。早上我们7:30都到店里了，然后我老公就和面、揉面，然后又搓面。这个面它的工序很多嘛，因为它都是手工的。
The noodles are made fresh every day. The dough is simple, just flour, salt, and water mixed together. But it's the way they knead the dough that gives the noodles their unique stretch.
揉面它就一直顺着一个方向这样子揉，它有的人不会揉面，两边折着揉，这样面越揉越劲大，越揉越揉不光。
They let the dough rest, divide it, and brush the pieces with oil.
我觉得彪彪面最难的过程是它和面的时候掌握的这个软硬程度。制作过程最重要的就是它和面的时候是注意水分与面粉的比例。
This is Dou Hao, he's Wang Mei's son. Because of COVID-19, he left his job and came back home to work at the restaurant, where he's learning how to pull noodles with his dad.
我的计划就是先把这个手艺，做面的手艺先学好。
Making the dough elastic is the most important part.
蜂蜜一样，就是它特别的柔软，你就把它面就和不到一块了。
But if the texture is right, we can go from this to this. 所以 what should a good biang biang noodle taste like?
客人来，他点面，完了后我们把面擀宽以后下到锅里，叫我们陕西人说的话，它就是薄。筋光，吃到嘴里软和，而且还不是很嫩的那一种。
Then the toppings are added.
它配上炸酱、肉臊子、西红柿、油泼辣子，啊，再就上两瓣蒜。当你吃到嘴里，你就感觉它了咋咧。因为我刚开始开的时候，我请教一个老师傅，他现在已经人都不在了，他给我们一手传的这个传下来，我一直按他的这个方法弄下来的。他给我说的，面不要放太多的佐料，太多的佐料不好吃，你就简简单单的原汁原味的还是可以坚持下来的。
Two decades later, this family-owned noodle shop is still going strong, with mother, father, and son all working together.
后来中间有几次我都想放弃不干了。哎，咋说呢，我在这中山街也二十多年了，跟这条街也有感情了，跟我的老顾客也有感情了。所以我还舍不得，就慢慢把这延续下来。
And her son hopes to keep things going.
父母的体力啊，就是各方面精力啊，都是有限的。然后我又想，我又这么年轻，而且我也是从小吃这个面长大的，我也对他有这种热情，就是喜欢这种面，所以我就回来，也就说把这个面，继续经营下去。
This is a Chinese noodle dish called Mao Er Duo, which literally means cat ears in Chinese.And they're called that because, well, they look like cat ears. Today, we're in Shanxi, a province in northwestern China with a 2,000-year history of making noodles.
陕西人他就比较爱吃面嘛。
It's the home of Dao Xiao Mian, or knife-cut noodles, Yo Mian, which are made out of oat, and, of course, Mao Er Duo.And this shop has been making Mao Er Duo for 15 years.
哦，小时候就家里面的那个父母呀，那个姥姥给做这些Mao Er Duo，当时吃就觉得特别好吃。
Mao Er Duo is similar to orecchiette, which also means ear in Italian. They're both made with wheat and water. Though orecchiette is older, invented in the 13th century.Mao Er Duo's earliest mention is in the 18th century, and it was allegedly discovered by the Qianlong Emperor. Traditionally, they're made like this.
拿筷子一颗一颗做嘛，所以说是，它也是属于山西一种，老点的面食吧。
But nowadays, there's a machine for it. The restaurant gets its Mao Er Duo from a shop that specializes in machine-made noodles.
好，你看这多少钱？你过来称一下。38.9，是吧？
嗯，
那就算39就行了哈，好吧？
你这个猫耳朵，咱们用量太大了。你要是自己做的话，它根本就赶不上用。我选他家猫耳朵，就是他家的猫耳朵比较筋道。
这个其实这个做个猫耳朵吧，也不是难。做猫耳朵的话，主要第一步主要是和面，这面粉和水混合。这主要第二步呢，和好面，我们把和好的面弄到猫耳朵机器上面，没啥，主要是机器自己做。我平均的话，每天做100多斤猫耳朵。他这个要的猫耳朵，有的要的不一样，有厚的，有薄的，有的要干点的，有湿点的，这个都是看客户要求。
Back at the restaurant, the noodles are cooked in this clay pot.
主要一开始干它吧，就是因为没有工作嘛，想找一个，就是想创业自己干点什么事情嘛。经过考察吧，觉得这砂锅还是可以。我们山西的本地的那种黑砂锅，做出来味道更好一点。砂锅放猫耳朵的话，它不容易浓，而且容易入味儿。猫耳朵吧，它这些东西它吃，它因为它这个形状的问题吧，它又比较入味儿，也比较筋道。我15年从来没有变过。还有肉汤呀，我管这种配料就有几十种这种药材。有好多种菜的，有生菜呀、面筋呀、 土豆呀、海带呀、鹌鹑蛋呀这些的。砂锅煮出来，它这个汤越到后面吃，它越浓，这个黑砂锅。旺季的时候，就冬天天气凉的话，就卖到200到300来。要是淡季，就夏天它属于淡季嘛，就100来来。15年了吧，最后成就感觉就是，这么多年老顾客他就有的就吃了15年，我干15年，他们吃15年，哎呀，我就觉得他们吃的就是特别满意口，哎呀，我也觉得特别开心，
挺有味儿。越吃越香，这个汤啊喝见还挺那深的，看见挺好，喝着嘴里还有一种甜麻麻的那种味道，觉得吃哈他就有想还想来吃的感觉。
So these coils of dough are actually Chinese noodles.But instead of wheat, they're made of oat. These oat-based noodles are called you mian. Mian means noodle, and you comes from you mai, which is a type of oat native to the alpine regions of China, specifically the mountains of Shanxi province, where the dish comes from. And it's been around for about 1,000 years.
我老家是进了县的，因为进了县呢就生产这个油面，从小呢就是那边以前白面大米很稀缺的。
Jingle County is located 6,500 feet above sea level, so not much grows there.
那里的常识是不是就是油面土豆。
The oats are also used to make dumplings and 油面鱼鱼 which are boiled oat noodles.Compared to wheat noodles, oat noodles have a nuttier taste and they're slightly coarse.
因为很早之前嘛，那他地方地势穷，哎，然后就喜欢吃这个东西，吃了以后扛饿。
油面 takes a lot of skill to make, mostly because of how delicate it is. The dough is made by mixing together ground oats and water until it becomes a paste.But since oat flour doesn't have gluten, which is the protein in wheat that makes dough stretchy, oat flour is a lot harder to shape. So how does she do it? In one quick motion, the paste is spread out and rolled up into a tube. It's said that this tube looks like a basket. That's why sometimes this dish is referred to as 油面烤姥姥. 烤姥姥 is a local word for basket.Then placed in the steamer and cooked for 5 to 6 minutes.
这蒸的时候呢，这个油面比较特殊，中间不能漏气，不能揭开来检查它熟没有，就是看好时间，几分钟就几分钟。漏了气之后九蒸不熟，做一道菜应该是挺费劲的。对于我们饭店来说，这是一个慢工艺做的菜，大概至少得20分钟才能吃得到，要有耐心。好的油面呢，做出来之后呢，它口感筋道。味道极佳，不好的油面呢它会粘在上面不好吐。
It's usually served with a collection of different sauces, like this tomato garlic sauce, this sauce made with lamb, potato, and tofu, and this chili scallion vinegar dip.
醋也是山西的特产的，那葱油烹调之后呢加上醋，这个味蘸烤姥姥也特别合适，还有油面特有的香味，吃起来蘸了西红柿之后呢它是咸酸口的，蘸上这个羊肉臊子之后呢它这个油面又有一定的吸附作用，它的烤肉它因为很薄很那啥，有一定的吸附作用。到发展到现在呢，好多像我们这些年轻的已经遗忘了，有的不会做了，因为它是一种粗粮，有些买了机器的，一年省几万块钱人工费啊，像我这里做呢就是你看啊，听的阿姨呢都是老家请过来的，我们一个地方请过来，就是做了几十年那个东西，地地道道的手工味，在我小时候都是，就是油面就是常识，从小吃到大，完了，小时候有可能有一段时间是吃腻了吧，但是现在长大了，出来社会上之后，外面世界吃白面吃大米的时候多了，突然间觉得现在这个 吃这个粗粮，吃这个油面的，又健康，哎，吃起来口感的各方面特怀念那种感觉。这一方水土养一方人。